Hey everyone, it's Jacqueline at Pixie Dust PhD. My partner Adam and I have been staying at Disneyland Paris at the Hotel New York, The Art of Marvel. We booked a one large double bed sized room with one sofa bed with a garden terrace. We are in room 184. Upon check-in, they did call it a king size bed. I don't know about the conversions to like American standard size beds, but I can tell you it feels bigger than our American queen. I'm not sure if it's quite the same size as an American king, but when they say large double, they really do mean it. And you'll see the bed in a minute. We booked a 2-night stay here. So 2 nights at the hotel, 3 park days. We've already slept here for 1 night. I think I know the room pretty well. So if you want to check it out, stay tuned. Room 184 is on the ground floor, or floor zero. It does go by the sort of European system where the first floor is zero or ground, not necessarily floor one like in America. So you can see we are here, 184. And this is the layout of the building we're in. I believe it's the Gramercy building. Got your pretty standard hotel door. It is a little bit of a narrow entryway, but not really any problem. As you're entering, directly to the left of your door is your closet. So here you can see there's an extra pillow and blanket up top, this big shelf, and then a bunch of hanging space. It is not the tallest hanging space. When my longer dresses did sort of pull up on the bottom here. Additionally, your iron and ironing board are stored in here, and it does take up a decent amount of space. So I actually moved some hangers outside of the closet. I'll show you the ironing board in a second. Still on your left from when you enter, next to the closet is this nice bench space. You can definitely sit here. We're also just storing some things here. We've got toiletries and small luggage, another extra pillow and blanket, some of my sweaters. And again, I just put some hangers out here. There is a bar here if you want to use it to hang things. And below the bench is just empty space. You could definitely fit a suitcase down here. Then we've got the safe. Here is where our hairdryer was. Another bar if you want to hang some things. And below the safe is just the set of drawers. The bottom two are fairly deep. The rest are a little more shallow, but they're totally functional. And inside this top drawer is your information for doing laundry. So you can pay the hotel to have some of your items laundered. Otherwise, just normal drawers. Storing our things. And the safe is definitely big enough for your passports and such, probably big enough for a small laptop. Back to as if you were entering, directly to your right. First off, you have these light switches. So these two work for the bathroom. This is a switch for the light directly above us. Ta-da! As well as some of the other overhead lights. So let's go ahead and go into the bathroom. Got the sliding door, and it's actually fairly large. The tile switches over when you enter into the bathroom. There's a large mirror with a light around it, as well as a separate makeup mirror with a light. It is 5x magnification, I believe. There's this audio in port. I haven't tested this. Perhaps you can play some music in the bathroom if you want. A plug for the shavers, and then also a standard outlet. The sink is pretty large, and there is an okay amount of counter space. For two people, I think it's actually decent. More than two people might be tough, but there's quite a lot of storage below the sink, which is super nice. So we've stored some of our bathroom things there. And then even below that, if you wanted to use, you could put some things on the ground, plenty of space. We get 2 cups. Here is the hand soap. Pretty cool. This is a fresh one. That's what it looks like wrapped. And then you also get this amenity kit. It has cotton pads, Q-tips, a shower cap, and a nail file, I believe. Here's your shower. So it's a walk-in shower. This glass door does open, make it easier to get in and out of. And then it comes with sort of an overhead waterfall shower as well as a handheld one. And these are the products you're given. So you get body wash, shampoo, and conditioner. They do come in these large mounted situations though, so nothing to take home. Also, I don't know why, but this one is mounted slightly lower than the others. The detail-oriented person in me is bothered. If you want to switch between the two shower heads, you either pull this knob out or push it in. And here's some cool tile detailing. There's a light in the shower, which is nice. A little shelf here to store your things. A bar here to hang towels. And then here is where our bath towels were put. The water temperature was really good. The water pressure leaves something to be desired. It's not terrible, but I wouldn't really want to wash my hair in the shower, for example, so I'm just not going to. Also, at least in our room, the little squeegee at the bottom of this glass door doesn't do a ton, so there's literal pools of water all along here. Like, our bath mat was just absolutely soaked, and I don't think there was anything we could do about it. Then you have this little room inside of your bathroom, which has the toilet. So first, there's these two wall mounts, presumably to hang towels or anything else. And then your standard toilet. There's not a trash can in here, but they do provide a little sanitary bag, so you can take that out to the trash can under the sink. And a little shelf. I kind of wish there was a piece of art in here or something. It's a little bit plain, but it's really large for a hotel bathroom, I think, and super functional for at least two people. So that's your whole entryway. You have your door, your actual closet, this sort of bench slash closet slash shelf space, some additional hanging space, your safe, these drawers, some light controls, and then your bathroom. There is this pretty much full length mirror here next to the bathroom. And then you move into your living space. So it is still this tile or laminate, I'm not entirely sure, but they do put a very large rug in the living space area. So the whole bed, most of the couch. So no worries about cold feet. To the left, you have your adjoining door. We've propped up the ironing board and iron here just to press some of our clothes. Since we don't need the adjoining door function, you could also store luggage here. It's a pretty big space. And turning around, this is the bed. Again, it was marked as a large double online. They called it a king at check-in. You get this fun runner. Adam's using the decorative pillow and the back of his head. The pillows are two different kinds, which is nice. There's a quite thin one, and then a much thicker, squishier one. So depending on your preference, there's probably a pillow for you. There is no top sheet. I'm finding out maybe that's not a thing in France, so you just sort of get under the cover, the duvet, but it is nice and plush, very comfortable, no complaints. Then on this side, there's a piece of artwork of Spider-Man. You want to go to sleep next to Spider-Man? Here's your AC unit. I've turned it off just for the audio on the video, but it works very well. There is one outlet down here, which I'm using for a long phone cord. And then this is the side table for this side of the bed. There is one actual outlet here, no USBs. And then these are all various light switches. So the ones that look like this control these reading lights. This middle one controls this big beam light, which is pretty cool. This one controls some overhead lights over the TV. And this is kind of like a master switch. And then you just got this nice side table that you can put all your things on. In front of the bed, it's actually part of the bed frame, there's this little seat, which is really nice to just, you know, throw your things on or sit down to help put shoes on. I will say though that this, since it is connected to the bed, it's hard, it's like wood. And you know, if you kick it, it's gonna hurt in the middle of the night. Similarly, the headboard is not padded at all. Yeah, pretty tough, so you'll want to use those pillows for sure. And then on the other side of the bed, you have a very similar setup in terms of side table. But you do get a USB outlet here for some reason and not on the other side. And then also the phone was here. And the bed is raised enough to store some things under it. So we've got two of our suitcases down there. And then we're using this part sort of under the bench to line up our shoes. Turning around, you've got this big thing. It's not quite a mirror, and that's because this is actually your TV. But the glare on this is terrible, I'm sure as you can tell, so I'll show you some footage of the TV once we turn off all the lights. I'll insert it here. But if you do want to watch TV, you're probably going to have to turn your lights off. Your TV's over this desk area. Nice and sleek. Here are a bunch of different kinds of outlets. Got a couple USBs. And if you did want to HDMI or USB into the TV, this is where those controls are. There's this nice chair, trash can, a whole big coffee and tea setup, including this drawer of many various kinds of products. And you've got disposables, but also these really pretty glasses in an ice bucket, which is a little rare in my opinion for traveling in Europe. Definitely an American thing. And this contains your mini fridge. Yay. So it's a decent size. It could definitely hold a lot. You don't have a microwave or anything though, so keep that in mind. But definitely nice for waters, drinks, etc. Next to your TV slash desk slash coffee area is this other really cool piece of artwork. There's more outlets down here. This oversized chair, it's a really fun accent pillow. And again, we're storing a suitcase under here. And turning around, here is your sofa. This does convert into a pull-out bed. It's also this small table that you can very easily move. And the side table for the sofa is basically the same story. One plug and then some lights. And there's this really neat floor lamp. They've stuck with this sort of shape and theming for the lights, and I think it's pretty cool. Behind that, you'll see this huge wall of curtains. We are on the ground floor and we do have a terrace room, so this is a glass door out to our terrace behind the curtains. If you were not on the ground floor, I suspect this would just be windows. I'm not sure if there are balconies. The building doesn't really look like it, but I suppose it depends on what kind of room you would book. So these overlapped plenty. We didn't find the need to like clothespin them shut in the night or anything, which is nice. Just open that up. You've got wall back there, and then this turns into a door. And you do have the sheer curtain. Pull that back. And there is your little terrace. A little hard to see from here, but those green tents, that's security to get into Disney Village. So we are extremely close. This room specifically, 184. There's an exit in the hallway just that way. And then you leave, take a left, and you're basically at the tents. Let's take a step outside real quick. It's actually a really nice cool day today. First cooler day since I've been in France, honestly. So here is our little chair and table set up. You can see the neighbors, a couple other rooms here. Disney Village. And then yeah, that's what the door back in looks like. Pretty sleek, pretty cool. Looks like a window, but it's a door. All right, and back in the room, we were also given this folder on our table. It has just some basic information. This here is the room service menu. We won't go through the whole thing, but you can get lunch and dinner from 11 to 10:30, and then night service is 10:30 to 7. So things are available basically all the time. A decent variety of foods, snacks, and of course there's also drinks. You've got cold drinks, hot drinks, juices, alcohol, etc. And this was in both English and French. Then there is a guest survey if you would like to fill it out. including a special section to shout out a cast member if you want. There's a little insert for operating the Lavazza coffee machine, so if you don't know what you're doing, here is how you do it. And there's the menu you can fill out and hang it on your door to get breakfast. You can pick a time slot between 7 and 11 a.m. So really there's kind of 24-hour service to some extent. Breakfast is pretty standard. Cereal, yogurt, fruit and cheese, lots of drink options, eggs and toast, Captain Marvel waffle, then you've got pancakes, French toast, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, that's the welcome folder. All right, leaving the room, we're gonna head over to the gym pool area. You do pass by the design studio, so taking a peek. Here is the gym, very modern, extremely gorgeous and tall ceiling. All right, in the locker rooms, you have to go through these to get to the pool. There's tons of lockers, store your things for free. The locker room also has a small sauna area. The pool has an indoor and outdoor portion. When we were here, both were set to 28 Celsius and the jacuzzi was 32 Celsius. For what it's worth, body temperature is approximately 37 Celsius, so 32 Celsius is probably not even 90 degrees Fahrenheit, so the jacuzzi was nice, but it's bath water, it's not hot. Overall, it's themed to the New York Metro. Metro pool, get it? Here's the general layout. Again, you've got the outside basin and the indoor basin. I'm here at night, so the outside is closed. Closed at 8 p.m. while we were here. I'm not a big pool person, so I don't have a ton to say, but it was a nice pool area. I have no complaints. All right, let's get back to the room. Let's take another look at that artwork with some final thoughts. So the room was fairly expensive, I'm not gonna lie. It was a lot cheaper earlier. We just weren't able to sort of commit and pull the trigger at that time. So you are definitely paying for the niceness of the room as well as the proximity to the parks. The Disneyland Hotel is much, much closer. But that is closed currently, so I think this is your closest option right now, and rates may reflect that. Plus, we are here during high season in late August. The room is definitely comfortable though, for sure for two people. We fit easily, there's spaces spread out, the bathroom is big, everything is comfy, the bed is nice, the pillows are nice. Towels are not the most plush, not gonna lie. For a hotel that costs as much, that could be a little nicer, but in general, I'm really happy with everything. Oh, also there is no free lotion, so if you are used to getting free lotion at hotels, that's not happening at the Marvel Hotel. On average, I would say we probably walk faster than most folks, but it does take us about 10 minutes to get from our room to the parks, and just a tiny bit longer to get back from the parks to our room, because again, like I said, we have an exit right at our hallway that goes out and basically straight to security, but when we're coming back, that's like an exit only door, you can't go back in through it, so we do have to go a little further and then into the back way to the lobby and then back to our room. Overall, I think if you can afford it, I would definitely recommend staying here. It's a really well-appointed hotel. And for us, a key concern was air conditioning. Some of the other hotels I'm sure are great, but definitely are a little bit older. And since we were here during August and it has been quite hot, we were very concerned about making sure the air conditioning in our room worked. I'm super happy to report that's not been a problem here. Also included as part of your stay at the Marvel Hotel is a heroic superhero encounter. It's basically a huge Instagram room. You do get one meet and greet with an actual Avengers character. For us, that was Black Widow, and there was a photo pass photographer there. And then you just move through the room in various sets where you are kind of acting out scenes or pretending to be superheroes like Iron Man and Captain Marvel, etc. So, I mean, it was cheeky and a little cheesy, but it was fun, it was cute, it took us about a half hour, and if you're paying to stay here, you may as well take advantage of that, because I do believe that is only for hotel guests. We also really enjoyed our meal at Manhattan, which is one of the table service restaurants here. It's the one that's not a buffet, and the Skyline Bar is also great. The bartenders know what they're doing, the cocktails are really well thought out initially, and then also really well made and executed. I do wish there was a quick service restaurant here, but that's just a general wish about Disneyland Paris hotels overall. It's not specific to the Marvel Hotel. But yeah, like I said, if you can afford it, for us, this might be our only time ever at Disneyland Paris, so I did kind of prioritize spending a little bit more to get the best experience and the most reliable air conditioning, since this is a relatively newer redo of the building. I would recommend it. If you have any questions about our experience, leave those in the comments down below and I will do my best to get back to you. And if you found this helpful, please remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate you being here and I hope you enjoyed this room tour and a bit of opinions about our stay at the Marvel Hotel. May the rest of your day be magical, and we'll see you real soon at Pixie Dust PhD.